structures here of the crevasses like that, yes? Yeah. That's the whole water creation, all coming all the way from down there with that little stream that we were walking with, yes, along, and creating, going under the glacier here, feeding that whole stream and creating that. And it was like basically before it was covered everything, yes, and during the winter it will be covered again. Like when we have the edges like that, we try to avoid the old edge.
이게 저런 게 있으면 저거 짚지 말라고 저렇게 빨리 써줄 수 있으니까.
Okay? Because that's constantly kind of like gonna be this baby. Try to take it harder so you have a stable kind of like walking.
여기 한번 써있어요.
A couple of steps here. I put you on the side.
Okay.
You want one with the middle?
Maybe I'll just stand here.
Yeah. Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
This like a picture too?
한 시간 줄까?
응.
No.
He can take your picture.
Can you take one in camera first?
Yeah. See? You already hired. Take one of his face because after a couple of years he's gonna say, who was that guy you were on the glacier with?
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
Perfect. Who did you go there with? And also my husband always, I wasn't there. I said, yes, you were. Let's go, guys.
Whenever you're ready.
So let me tell you, since they are down there, I can tell you a little bit about those little peaks that you can see in the glacier. So they called seracs, and seracs. They are basically. Okay, so maybe we can come check with before the cruise. I don't know if it's gonna go there or not. Okay, so let me tell you about those seracs now. So those whole peaks are called seracs of the glacier that you can see, and they are caused by the fractures in the glacier and snow accumulation. You can see the blue ice in them, very exposed, because they have they are easily can be broken off. So the process of breaking them off, if they are breaking off, is called calving. It's like from calf, like when the calf is giving birth to the cow, the same way glacier is giving kind of like a birth to the icebergs. And as you can see below, there is all the icebergs flowing in the water, which is like very nice. I don't know exactly, but you don't want to end it up there. So it's nature, so you might be lucky, I don't know, but this is like a very slowly, sometimes it's falling, you can hear it pretty strong. When it's falling, unfortunately,
we cannot see. Let's
go. Yes, you see, because those glaciers are more receding, ours is more stable.
Okay.
But it's falling still, this is not like it's like on the picture only and it's gonna be the same forever. So it's changing dynamic, it's falling. Cracks appearing. You can see the sediment, black sediment down beneath, down in the middle here. That means that basically there was some breakage, there was already silt and other material growing from the. Because remember, we are looking at the plant again.
So that last step can be a doozy.
So the material is still moving forward with the flow of gravity. So imagine that whole material getting into the falls, crevasses, bringing fishing material. It's dynamic like no. Like we cannot even comprehend with our minds, you know, how it's working there, yes, the nature. So that's basically what we can see here. And my goodness, something, I don't know, the more we stand, we're going to go down below, there is another chance that we can hear something or see something, you know, who knows. But it's not like that. Like for example, like for 2 weeks I've been here, I didn't see any kind of a feeling of problem. But I see every month. There was one of the peaks broke off and bring some of the snow down. You see the pile of snow that is at the bottom on that one side there? Yeah. Not to the left all the way, there are two piles, but there's the right one. That fell to the ground. And that peak, you see, like right above, the first peak broke off. And the snow went down there and it's actually ended up in the water somehow. Those crevasses are always moving in the winter time. All that area, mountain area, is frozen. So we can walk on it. We bring people on sleds. Climb up? No, I mean like going into the crevasses back there from the face of the glacier. There's no accessibility. Mm-hmm. And they are more stable too, I think, the winter, because the winter is the time when the temperatures are dropping dramatically. Like end of the summer, so you know, still there is a process. We have to constantly maintain the trail. Go down.